Thank you for watching Urban TV, People and Profiles. I am your host, Jackie Achan. My guest on the show tonight, she is the first daughter as well, that is Patience Museveni Rabogo. She is an author, a farmer, a businesswoman, and a mother. Remember, this is the second part of our conversation with Patience Museveni Rabogo. For those who missed part one of this conversation, you can find it on our YouTube channel. Last week, we discussed a little bit of the book, Jesus's Africa. It is quite an interesting title for the book. I would like to know what actually inspired this title for a book and your reason for writing it.
The book came out of some teachings that I had been doing during lockdown. When lockdown happened, we had to go online. And so it really gave me the opportunity to condense some of the teachings that we have shared over years into a more, because these messages, I've shared them sort of in different sort of forums. But in lockdown, I really felt the Lord say, now put it into a concise message, put everything into a message, specific message. So as I started sharing these messages, the response that I was getting from people outside Uganda, you know, many people hearing these messages saying that this has been a word from God for them, it has helped them to make decisions about what they're going to do with their business, with their family. And so I felt the Lord continue to sort of lead me to put it into a book format. So I had the teachings and I started, you know, sort of, we transcribed the teachings because they were audio teachings, they were messages. So we transcribed them into sort of written messages. But as I was doing that, I felt the Lord say, I want you to share your journey now, your personal journey along with these messages, which was a bit different because it was easy to preach or to teach. But to share your journey is like now you're opening yourself up to be vulnerable and say, okay, this is how God has led me. And so that was a bit of a challenge for me. I was like, oh God, maybe I just share the message, you know? And he said, no, I want you to share your journey because the message is out of the journey. It doesn't just drop from the sky. It's actually, it's birthed out of experience and challenges and struggle, and that's how it comes. You know, just like a baby is not just, doesn't fall from the sky, it comes from really the struggle. So the Lord started really challenging me to write down my own journey alongside of it. Yeah, so that's when I started writing. Jesus's Africa, I think that is because that is really the vision. That's the vision that he gave to us. It was about this continent that I love, that I believe we all love, that we're really praying and believing that it can Africa can come into her purpose, and that I believe from my own experience is that I didn't come into my own purpose apart from Jesus. Jesus really is that driving force that helped me to find my identity, find my purpose, find direction. And I believe that's the same for the continent. Even the themes and the topics that keep coming up, I would never have really known them apart from that revelation from God, because it's out of that continual revelation that they became more and more clear, the sort of the roots of our, the spiritual roots of our problems and, you know, our issues or historical struggles as a continent, as a people. So all these things really came out of my searching with God, and so I felt that it's just sort of the full picture of the vision that he has been giving.
Okay, briefly, what should a reader expect from this book that you have authored?
Well, I really trust that the Holy Spirit is able to do greater work than any of us is able to do. Many times when you preach a message, so many people will tell you different things that they have gotten out of the message. So But my prayer is that it will be an encouragement. An encouragement to believers, to Christians who are out there maybe asking God about what is his plan for their life, what is his purpose. I hope it will be an encouragement to the church in Africa and also in the diaspora, that this is really the time for Africa to arise and that the church has a really important role to play. I just hope that it will young people who are also seeking God about their future, their destiny, who have big questions, to trust God for his plan for their lives. I just hope that someone maybe hears, reads it and it speaks to them personally and encourages them maybe in whatever they are facing, that, you know, God has a plan. Sometimes you are sort of our energy is taken in what we're going through right now. But if you get encouragement, you know that God has a plan. Don't give up. Keep moving. Keep trusting God. Keep going forward. So I share in the book about Jesus's the commission, the Great Commission. It says, "Go make disciples of all nations." And how many times we have interpreted it as Christians as go and get people saved, and then that's it. As long as they are saved and in church, it's finished. And yet the nation remains, you know, with different issues and different challenges. And so I think that what I share in the book is that I believe that according to the Bible, if you read the book and the different examples I give from the Old Testament and the New Testament, I believe that the role of the church is to be the salt and the light and to help the nation cross over into her destiny. If you look at the Old Testament, the role of the priesthood was almost central to the nation of Israel. If the Battle of Jericho, it was the priesthood that went before. The crossing of the Red Sea, it was the priesthood that went before. There was a merging of really the priesthood and almost governance, and it was so the treatment of people who were sick, law giving, everything was really in the priesthood. So I believe that the church has a real role to play in discipling the nation, and that doesn't mean creating a theocracy. I believe the church's role is through influence. It's not through, you know, in our church history we have the Inquisitions and Crusades where the church or Christian nations were trying to impose Christianity on others. I don't believe that's what it means to go make disciples. I believe that making disciples is through preaching the gospel, is through influencing people, influencing the nation positively, just like light, just like salt. So I really feel that there needs to be a bit of a paradigm shift, that because if Reformation was about how many people go to church, then Africa would be the most reformed continent, because we have the biggest, there is an explosion of, you know, church growth, church, you know, people being saved. But for that to translate into reformation in society, I believe that there needs to be a paradigm shift in the church to know that it's not just about people coming to church and being in church. It's about those same people now having influence, being an influence in the nation, taking the kingdom.
Well, let's hold it there. We are in conversation with Pastor Patience Museveni Rabogo. She is a mother, a daughter, a Christian woman, an industrialist, an agriculturalist, a book author, and all these things. We are having this conversation with, Patience to get to know the journey of her life and inspire, you know, people out there who might want to take the same journey just like Patience did. We will take a short break, and when we come back, we shall continue with this conversation on people and profiles on Urban.